If you haven't been keeping track, Snow White and the Huntsman is the second high-profile reimagining of Snow White to hit theaters this year and the third overall if you count that one TV show. A fourth version of the story was also recently in production as a martial arts fantasy set in feudal China, but it was just scrapped. Why is Snow White so damn popular right now? I have no idea, really. But if I had to venture a guess, I'd say it's because Hollywood still only just found out that genre movies targeted at women can actually make money, and doing a dark version of a Disney princess was everyone's first idea of how to capitalize on this while spending as little effort as possible. As for why it's Snow White specifically, well, okay, I'm not a member of the female audience, so this is obviously all conjecture, but I suppose the argument could be made that the Snow White story is one of the few fairy tales with both a female hero and a female villain whose respective characters both speak, metaphorically at least, to relatable, uniquely female experiences. In case you forgot, the story of Snow White is that a beauty-obsessed wicked queen freaks the hell out because her stepdaughter has, hit puberty, come of age, whatever, and now she, meaning the queen, is no longer the hottest catch in the family. Again, this is all conjecture, but I kinda have to think that the broader symbolism of Snow White's story, i.e. a young girl whose entire world gets yanked out from under her up to and including the sudden resentment by other female acquaintances simply because she's crossed the invisible line, whereby one becomes an acceptable object of sexual desire, and the Wicked Queen story, i.e. a woman watching what power the world has afforded her diminished by the arrival of a quote-unquote new model, might resonate with female audiences in a profound and specific way. Focusing on that idea might actually make for an interesting movie, and while this film does pay some lip service to the idea of the Wicked Queen as being in part both a victim and byproduct of a world that held physical beauty as the only form of power a woman could hope to wield, but it never really affects anything other than a thinly sketched backstory for the aforementioned villainess. Otherwise, the main focus here is taking the basic Snow White story beats that everyone remembers from the Disney version and dressing them up with visuals and story cues borrowed wholesale from Lord of the Rings, Game of Thrones, Miyazaki movies, and anything else that's recently made money in the fantasy genre. Charlize Theron is the Wicked Queen, here reconstituted as an ageless, all-powerful sorceress who stays beautiful by draining the life essence of young girls. Kristen Stewart plays Snow White, here reconstituted as the hell if I know, honestly. Despite ostensibly being the star of the movie, Snow White has no discernible character, no real motivation, no visible emotional rationale for why she does anything she does. Sometimes she's just trying to save her own life, other times it's about avenging her father the king, later on she's a Joan of Arc-style revolutionary, it's implied that she has some kind of supernatural powers and or prophesized destiny but only works sometimes, for some reason cutting out her heart will make the queen immortal for good. Actually, her character forms a perfect microcosm for the entire movie, in that it only sort of makes sense if you force yourself to never ever ask the question, why? It honestly feels like a lot of rewrites and tinkering happened on this thing, to be fair. They've released it as Snow White and the Huntsman, but the Huntsman doesn't actually have all that much to do in the story. He's there a whole lot and ticks off some story points, but he doesn't really drive the plot, and they don't really fully commit to him as the love interest. And he's not even the only one of those. Yeah, you wouldn't know it from the advertising, which has unsurprisingly chosen to highlight that, hey, one of the Avengers is in our movie! But there's also still a version of the Prince Charming character in this thing, too. After all, hackneyed love triangles is something that Hollywood now believes must be included in every female-targeted genre movie. I honestly wouldn't be surprised to learn that the Prince guy was supposed to be a way bigger deal in this, and the Huntsman kinda sorta being Snow White's real romantic interest was intended as a big surprise twist, which it now isn't because of the title and,
hey, one of the Avengers is in our movie!
Meanwhile, the film seems to keep forgetting that Prince What's-His-Name even exists. Oh hey, the dwarves are actually in this too, and played by a bizarrely high-caliber cast of well-known actors at that. I can understand them not wanting anyone to know they were in this movie, but why is the movie keeping it a secret? To be honest, the only real reason to go see this, other than some isolated depictions of magical realms and fairy tale characters that are actually pretty damn interesting and imaginatively realized, is Charlize Theron. She's amazing in this. Theron is one of those talents that Hollywood doesn't always know how to use. She's one of the most gorgeous women on the planet, sure, but she's also an interesting and unconventional actress who's often much more engaging playing fierce, frightening, and even evil characters, despite the industry's understandable temptation to cast her as an ethereal goddess figure because, well, she looks like that. But here, she's pretty much playing Rita Repulsa, stomping around her throne room, screaming, ranting, making incredible angry faces, sending out minions to kill the heroes and browbeating them when they fail. It's a hell of an anti-star turn, the kind of go-for-broke, over-the-top maniac performance that mainstream movies seldom allow actresses to indulge in. She's not really good enough to save this movie, but in the totally separate movie she appears to be starring in is pretty damn great. See you next time!